Hello everyone, I'm here today to discuss with you all the topic Wild Bone as an animal fable and a beast fable. But before continuing with this topic, like this video and subscribe to my channel. Is Wild Bone an animal fable? Ben Jonson's Wild Bone is absolutely based on well-known animal fables. Most of the characters are named after animal who share their characteristics. For example, Wild Bone is crafty and is accordingly named after a fox. Additionally, the general structure of the story can be seen as analogous to an animal fable about a fox who fakes his death to catch greedy birds. As such, the play certainly relies upon elements of animal fables to discuss the state of human morality. However, Wild Bone is a little different from more conventional animal fables. While most animal fables use real animals to comment on human behavior, Jonson uses actual humans but names them after animals. Thus, the effect is a little different than the conventional animal fable. At the end of the day, Jonson still uses real human to explore real human activities, appetites and vices. And so, Wild Bone is not quite the same as a strict animal fable that takes place entirely within the animal kingdom. As such, I think it would be most accurate to say that though Wild Bone certainly relies heavily on the animal fable tradition, it should not be viewed in the same sense as a conventional animal fable. Wild Bone is a beast fable. In 20th century criticism, Wild Bone has been generally acknowledged as a beast fable. Beast fables are the stories about beasts in which human qualities are infused in non-human beings. The aim is to explore human follies or to convey moral message or both. Wild Bone in this sense is undoubtedly a beast fable. The characters of the play are beasts in human shape. The majority of characters derive their names from animals. The play also displays the bestial nature of the character. Significance of the names of the characters in Wild Bone. Wild Bone, the protagonist, is the cunning fox who tried to lure his prey by pretending to be sick and dying. Mosca, his parasite, is fleshfly, which feeds on everything it can sit upon. Appropriately, he tries to exploit the three legacy hunters and feed on the sickness of his master. The three legacy hunters owe their names to predatory birds. Walter is vulture. He is gifted with predatorily oriented eyesight. He does not have any family ties. Corbeccu is a raven. A raven was notorious for his hostility to its young ones. If they did not resemble it in this respect, Corbeccu, like a raven, tries to disinherit his own son Bonario, who is different from his father. Similarly, Corvino is crow. He is greedy of harvest. In the subplot, Sir and Lady Politic would be derived their names from the parrots. Like a parrot, Sir Politic has no imagination, but he has a capacity to imitate others. Lady would be exhaust everyone with her ceaseless chatter. Her imitation of the Venetian fashion also fits with her name and character. The punishment to these beast-like characters is given according to their nature and crimes. Wild Bone is crippled by iron chains in prison. Walter is exiled from the Society of the Learned Men and from Venus. Corbeccu is confined to the monastery, while Corvino is to be rode about in Venus. Sir Politic becomes a turtle when he hides himself in the tortoise shell. Peregrine, like a hawk, will take the tortoise high in the sky and then throw it on the earth to break the shell. To conclude, the great satirist and reformer Ben Jonson scolded men for correction. He laughs at men not with sympathy, but his laughter is curative. The beast fable technique help him to magnify and attack greed, hypocrisy, treachery, flattery, lust, and so on.